Hello you lovely people, how are you all doing this beautiful day?
I'm Eshna and I welcome you back to my channel.
From the title you're already aware that you are up for a fragrance review. This time I'm going to review the Plum Body Mist from this range of the Plum Body Loving Mist. I have these two mists right here. I will be reviewing these because I have tested these two out. I have two more body mist with me to review, but I will have to spend some time testing those so that I can formulate my thoughts and share it across with you. So if you're interested in that, stay tuned till the end for this one and wait for the other two. But before we get started with the review of these two, please make it a point that you are subscribed to my channel and ring the bell icon next to so that you are notified for all my future uploads. Now, let's dive into the video, ignoring all the background noises, and review these two fragrances, shall we? Okay, like every time, I'm going to talk about what's on my lips today. You're looking at a very gothic kind of a lips. I usually don't wear these colors because it's too dark for my liking. I am more into nudes and pinks and all. I love reds and browns as well, but not this dark brown. But of late, I have procured Max Verve, and this was pack of that trio from Shreya Jain's collaboration with MAC, and this is how Verve looks like. And Verve is today on my lips. I have never ever thought that I will enjoy these sort of colors this much, but as I see it, I am loving it. So that's what's on my lips today. Extremely happy to use this. It's very, very, very comforting. So it's not tugging and pulling and everything. It's a satin matte. It's hydrating for the lips, so it's not drying or anything. So it's a very comfortable wear. So with the lipsticks sorted, let's dive into these and talk about these in detail. So let me first talk about this one. This is the Body Loving, Plum's Body Loving Mist in the variant Oopsie Daisy. Look at the packaging of the outer side cardboard box. It's so summerish and so light. The cardboard box has got all the information that you need for the fragrance. On this side at the back, as well as some on the other side. I love the color scheme. It's orange here, it's yellow otherwise. So it's a very beautiful packaging, and when you open your fragrance, this is where your fragrance should be housed. I have taken it out and this is how the bottle looks like. Let's get into the bottle, and I mean, let's cover the bottle's packaging as well. I love this packaging. This looks so cute, it's so easy to carry around as well. It's a plastic bottle and it's a thick plastic. It's not that it's a flimsy one or a bad quality one. The plastic is very good. It is transparent, so you can actually see how much you have used up, which gives you fairly an idea about how when you should purchase another bottle. Because yeah, there might be another bottle for this case at least. So I've given it away too early in the video, but I love this one. The packaging is very nice. It is very different from the regular body mists and perfumes that we see. I love the black nozzle. It's quite nice. It's different, the black lid and all. Let's spray this and see what I feel. It smells, it sprays beautifully and it smells beautifully as well. The name Oopsie Daisy is 100% justified. It feels very fresh, it's very lively, floral, reminds you of summer in all its beauty. So definitely a summer vibe fragrance. You can definitely wear it in winters as well, don't get it wrong. It will smell incredible in winter as well. But then the color of the liquid and the scent essentially screams floral and summerish vibes. So that is what this scent is mainly about. Let's cover this a bit more in detail. Okay, so since the name is Oopsie Daisy, for sure you have daisy flowers inside it. So it's floral fragrance, but it's not only daisy that you are getting inside. You will get aloe vera inside as well as grapefruit notes in this. That means this is a fruity floral fragrance and somewhat very much a very lively, a very jovial, a very peppy fragrance. It's a very happy sort of a fragrance. If you want to represent happiness, this might be one of the fragrances that you will be reaching out to make yourself feel better as well as spread happiness around. It's such a lively, happy, jovial kind of a scent. It's very pretty. It's very nice. This one, like mists, you have the expectation of lasting maybe 1 or 2 hours, then you need to reapply. This lasts more than that if I compare, because this is something around 2 to 3 hours that I got a wear time out of this. And I'm talking about this time when this is autumn. It's not winters, it's autumn. And I have been testing this out maybe for the last 1 or 2 weeks. So at times it's hot that you require fan, and at times you don't. So we are in that transition period, and in transition period this is lasting for 2-3 hours. I hope this performs the same way in summers as well, because it is very pretty, it is sweet, it's very happy. Like I said, I think it'll last, hopefully it'll last for 2-3 hours in summers as well. If it does, then it's a great body mist that I would highly recommend it to everybody. This one, it says also, this is cruelty free, judgment free, nasties free. So it's good in every way. You can carry this around with you as well, so it's convenient from the packaging and everything. So I see no con in this fragrance, and I'm extremely happy that I purchased this. I laid my hands on this, and I would request you to at least give this one a try sometime. At least you won't regret it if you are into fruity floral fragrances. It's kind of an offbeat floral fragrance. It's not the regular floral fragrance. It's nice, and it's slightly heavier than the lighter floral fragrances, if I may say. The price point for this and the other one as well is ₹525, but for sure you will get tons of discount. Like when I purchased it, I remember I paid something around 430 or something like that, so I didn't pay the full price. So I would suggest not to do the same. Moving on to this one. This is the Orchid You Not variant. This is exactly on the same lines, the packaging. The bottle, if you look it closely, the shape of the bottle is printed on one side. So when you're looking at it, you get one half of the bottle. If you tilt it, you get the other half. So I love the packaging of the cardboard because a lot of thought has been put into it. It's clearly visible. I like the color scheme of this one as well because it's orchid. So you have this orchidy purple type of a color mixed with blue, so it's nice. And you have similar information on the back as well as on this side, so those are covered. And when you open the fragrance, this is how it is housed. When I take it out, this is how the Orchid You Not bottle looks like. Just look at this beautiful pink lavendery liquid and that same bottle shape and size. I love holding it even in my hand. It feels so nice. Let's spray this. The packaging is very nice for both of these. I can't choose which is better. Both are nice. The sprays work wonderfully for both of them. Okay. Orchid You Not is one of the most subtle, beautiful, elegant fragrance that you will see. Since this one is called Orchid You Not, so definitely it's a floral fragrance. But again, this is a fresh, happy, peppy floral, but which is very subtle and mild. It is not as strong as Oopsie Daisy. Oopsie Daisy comes out stronger. So if you are someone who tilts towards milder fragrance, this is the one for you. Oopsie Daisy might be strong for you. So if there is a chance to go to a store and give it a sniff, then you do that before you make a purchase for Oopsie Daisy. But if you are into milder fragrance or stronger fragrance, you are fine with both variety, then this is a safer purchase compared to Oopsie Daisy. It has got not only orchid in it, it has got aloe. Aloe is a common ingredient, it seems, for all the body mists, and this one is no exception. It also has freesia in it. Two floral notes are in here, which makes it a straight up floral fragrance, whereas the other one is a mix of floral fruity fragrance. This is clearly a floral fragrance. So if you're into milder floral fragrances, which creates a fresh, sweet appeal as well, then this is a great one to try. Orchid You Not is beautiful. I love it like anything. The only drawback, like for any mild fragrance, this one also has the same, it doesn't last. Since it's mild, it evaporates very fast. So it performs like a body mist actually. So it lasts not more than 1 hour
or 1.5 hours on your skin. Maximum maybe you will get a wear time of 2 hours if you're inside AC, you're not sweating and everything, or if you're wearing it in winters, because I can see only probably that this can be worn in winters, because in summers this smells incredible, but you won't be able to smell it on yourself or others because this will fade away very, very soon. Oopsie Daisy is a variant that will last a strong quite a lot in summers, in winters, I'm assuming summers as well, because it performed well in autumn. But this one, it didn't perform well in autumn as well. So in autumn, I'm getting a wear time of 1.5 hours. I mean, maximum, I'll say, because when I sprayed this on myself, it evaporated very soon. Surprisingly, this clings onto the clothes better, because my stole smelled like this even after 4 to 5 hours. I could smell bits and pieces of this on my stole. This one heavily stays on the clothes as well, because it retains that scent not only on your body but also on your clothes, and it continues doing it. So regardless of the fact that it's summer or winter, you can actually wear it. Others can sniff it on you. The lasting power might be lesser in summer, but it's stronger, so it will last a bit longer. This one won't perform the same way because it's mild. Like any other mild fragrances, it has got that performance level that it doesn't last long. Coming to projection, none of these project extremely well. There is a body mist. Extreme level of projection is not expected as well. So I understand that. Keeping that in mind, it's okay from the performance criteria, that the parameter itself is a body mist. It's not that we are looking at any EDT or EDP here. It projects nothing, I would say. I mean, you spray it, maybe what, 5 to 10 minutes, people will be able to smell, and after that, nothing, no recognition of it. But since it clings onto your clothes, the moment you enter into a room, the initial impression of this scent will hint, not this one, this one, will hint the noses of the people who are actually going to sniff it. But then that will also fade very easily. So I'm not saying that it's a great part from the projection or siage at all. It's terrible at the siage. It doesn't leave any trail at all. So that's the performance and all other aspect. The age group, I don't see any restriction on any age group. Everybody can wear it, but definitely peppy youth, young people, they are going to enjoy this more than very matured lady. If I have to put an age bracket, that is how I can see. But honestly, I don't see it as a restriction. I mean, I might be 50 or 40 or 60 or whatever might be my age. If I think I am into florals and I'm into peppy florals or I'm into subtle, I can go ahead and wear those. So yes, I have covered all the aspects. Do I recommend any of these? Of course. Oopsie Daisy is definitely for everyone who enjoys strong fragrances. Orchid You Not is for people who are into mild fragrances. But there are takers for both these categories out in the world, so I cannot negate one that one is bad, another one is good. No. You can enjoy my fragrance, Orchid You Not. If you enjoy strong fragrance, Oopsie Daisy. So that's the only difference. Apart from that, they are all same in all the categories. At least, I'll be honest, you're paying much less compared to some of the bigger names of body mists in the market. When you're paying around 400 or 500 and getting these mists, these are 100 ml, so it's good to try these out because they smell incredible. I cannot ever take that away, that the smell is incredible. So yes, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and it was useful for you. You can take an informed decision now whether to invest in these or whether you should wait for some other body mists or anything. I have 2 body mists from Plum with me right now which are waiting to be reviewed, so you will get to know about those in the upcoming days as well. But for these two, if you enjoyed this video, liked this, found this helpful, then don't forget to give this video a like, share it with your friends, and comment in the comment section if you have used either of these or you are on the same line with me when it comes to their appeal, and if my review is something that you think was justified and you enjoyed it. So we can get all chatting in the comment section and share our thoughts and opinion. And you'll get the link. These two fragrances in the description box below. In case you want to check it out, you can check the description box. You'll also get my social media details in the description box in case you want to follow me and stay better connected. But before you leave this video, if you have made it till this far, thank you so much for watching the entire video and getting through this entire review with me. But if you did, then you might as well subscribe to my channel because you hopefully have enjoyed my content. And when you do so, don't forget to ring the bell icon next to it so that you're notified for all my future uploads. I will see you in my next video. Till then, stay happy, stay healthy. Bye.